Actually, it is a love story we're going to talk about. Robert Schumann was very much in love with Clara Wieck. Clara Wieck was the daughter of the great piano teacher that Schumann visited and learned a lot from. But funnily enough, Friedrich Wieck didn't want Robert to marry Clara. So it was only in 1840 that Schumann could marry Clara. And they were both very happy. She was 10 years younger. But unfortunately, Robert Schumann always had a bit bipolar disease. He could be depressive and again exalted. So then Clara got an idea, because she was also a composer, that they could write counterpoint together. And especially they loved, of course, as we all do, they loved Johann Sebastian Bach and his counterpoint. So they sat there and made counterpuntal exercises together. Robert could also concentrate very much on that. So they were very happy together doing this. That was the way that Robert, during the 1840s, could write these pieces for organ and piano pedal. This piano pedal was Clara's idea, that she thought they should buy a home organ, but that was a piano with a pedal keyboard, also sounding like a piano. So that's why the pieces are called for piano pedal and for organ. You can do both. The wonderful thing about these pieces, especially the canonical variations, is that Schumann wanted so much that the listener should not think of all this learned counterpoint. They should enjoy the result. In this way, he would call it that the counterpoint, that is the roots of the music, and then when you listen to the music, that is the flower that grows out of the roots.